We start tonight with the celebrations for Korea's 98th Independence Movement Day. On this date in 1919, hundreds of thousands of Koreans poured into the streets to demand independence, bravely opposing Japan's brutal colonial rule of the country. Marking the annual celebration, acting President Hwang Kyo-ahn delivered a speech in place of President Park Geun-hye, who suspended pending a verdict in her impeachment trial. Song Ji-sun has our top story.
In order to carry on the legacy of the independence movement, Prime Minister and Acting President Hwang Kyo-ahn said the two Koreas must unite for a prosperous future, but expressed disappointment that the North has continually ignored the South's efforts and opted only to advance its weapons programs in blatant disregard for international norms. Denouncing North Korea's recent murder of Kim Jong-nam for its brutality and inhumanity, the acting president pledged stern countermeasures against Pyongyang's provocation.
UN 안보리 결의 등의 제재와 압박을 더욱 강화하여 북한이 잘못된 셈법을 꼭 바꾸도록 하겠습니다. 사드 배치 등 한미 연합의 억제 및 방어 능력을 배가하여 북한 스스로 핵무기가 소용없다는 것을 깨닫게 해 나갈 것입니다.
He vowed greater efforts to improve North Korea's human rights conditions and to set the groundwork for unification, asking the South Korean people to help North Korean defectors settle in the South.
북한의 실질적인 변화 없이 우리가 추구하는 통일은 이룰 수가 없습니다. 이를 위해서는 북한 주민들이 외부 세계를 알고 시대 흐름을 인식하도록 국제사회와 함께 적극 도와주어야 합니다.
Hwang also touched upon South Korea-Japan ties, saying the future of bilateral relations must develop in a mutually beneficial way. He stressed the two sides must work together to heal the wounds of history and recover the dignity of the Korean victims of Japan's wartime sexual slavery as reached in their landmark 2015 agreement on the issue. In his protest over statues installed in Korea to remember the victims, Japan has still not sent its ambassador and consul general in Busan back to Korea, nearly 2 months after they were recalled to Tokyo.
일본 정부도 역사를 있는 그대로 직시하면서 미래 세대 교육과 과거사의 과오를 반성하는 데 진정성 있고 일관성 있게 나아가야 할 것입니다.
Hwang touched upon the internal divisions within South Korea, with protests intensifying between those for and against the impeachment of President Park Geun-hye. The acting president wrapped up his speech by calling for national unity. He said society must acknowledge diversity and differences for balance and harmony built on respect for Korea's constitutional values. Song Ji-sun, Arirang News.